Okay, so here we are back in our crater field, and let's see what we can figure out. Let's see what we can figure out based on some of the features that we see here. Okay, so the first thing that I'll say is that we are in a lava field. That's why everything looks so dark. This is all the basalt here, so that we are in a maria, just flat out. Very dark looking background or sort of backdrop for this, okay? And what I can say, first of all, is that the craters DEL and Beketov. So that's the first thing we'll point out here. Base craters DEL and the Beketov. Can you tell when they would have formed relative to the lava flow? Just by sort of looking at it. So DEL and Beketov, when would they have flowed relative to the lava field? Okay, so my answer to that is they would have formed after the lava flow. How do I know that? Well, just sort of some common sense. You see this big black lava field all over the place with hardened lava, and on top of the lava flow, then the craters must have come in and gone bang, 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 like that. They must have just come in like that because the craters are on top of the lava, so you can see that they've obviously drilled into the lava after the lava was there. Kind of obvious, I know. Okay, but there's our start. The second thing is look at the Janson crater then. And by the way, the Janson crater is something like 24 kilometers. And for those of you maybe who are on the Central California coast, 24 kilometers is roughly the distance between San Luis Obispo and Santa Maria or something like that. So it's a pretty big crater, this distance right here. It's 24 kilometers, okay? And so if you look at the Janson crater, you can tell then, again, the same question, when did it happen relative to the lava flow? So I'm going to say the Janson crater is there before the lava flow. And how would I know that? Because look, you can see the crater right here. You can see it, but it's all filled in. It's filled in with lava. So the Janson crater must have been there first. Then the lava started to flow and just started to pool into the crater and filled it almost all the way at the top, so way you can just barely even see the rim of it. So there you go. So the Janson crater would be even older than the lava flow. And if that's not enough for this area right here, if you look at it then, you look at crater Y, when did crater Y happen? Well, it must have happened after the lava flow. That flow, because Y still looks pretty fresh, just like the other ones do. And so how unfortunate it is to live in this area right here. Not only did you get hammered by a huge crater that formed the Janson crater, then you got spilled over with lava and your crater got filled in. Then another meteorite came, bam, and hit you with Y at some point in your history. That's what I mean. Very violent start to the surface there. The next crater we'll look at over here is R. And you see that R here, you can just barely see the outline up there. And so sometimes for that reason, R here, I guess this is our fourth point right here. It's sometimes called a ghost crater because you can barely see it anymore, but it's definitely there. And you can also tell, ask the same question, when did R form relative to the lava flow? So I'm going to definitely go with after the lava. And how do we know that? Well, just sort of by looking at it. You can tell that the crater's there. You can tell that the crater's there. But it's obviously so filled in with lava that's almost spilling over the sides, but you can still see the outline of R. And there's another little ghost crater right there, likely the same thing happened right next to it. Yeah, the neighbor of R right there. And so basically the timeline that you can sort of derive from this thing goes something like this. Timeline goes something like this. I'll sort of summarize it down here at the bottom. So we sort of go from old over here all the way to young, sort of in a timeline. I wouldn't know exactly what dates we'd be talking about there. But it sort of looks like this. The oldest things that you'll find in this lava field here are the field craters, for sure. Those are things that were there first, definitely the oldest thing, because they were there when the lava flowed. Then what you're going to get after that is somewhere in the middle here would be the lava flow. So the lava flow definitely isn't the oldest thing that happened, because the craters were already there, and suddenly the lava started to flow. And the youngest thing that we see in this crater field right now are the clear craters, because they happened after the lava flow, and definitely a lot after the fill craters happened. So that's sort of my geosleuthing for you right here. I just find it interesting that you can sort of dive into the area like that, and just by some of the features, you can just tell, well, when the lava flowed versus when the crater formed. And so that's a little bit of geosleuthing on a crater field there on the moon. So in the next one, I'll sort of wrap this up by talking a little bit about some iron, which is also found on the moon.